they are. And it just requires that one step that these children have taken and have been where they are, from representing India at UNGA to surviving the streets and holding their aspirations tight. And we all need hope in the times that we are living in, right? It's an extreme pleasure. We have three of them with us who could join us, 15 children who feature in the book. Of them, we have the pleasure of having three of them join us. And without much ado, I would like to invite our CEO, Bidisha Pillai, on stage. Rashmi Bansal, the best-selling author, without whom it wouldn't have been possible, because she chose to partner with Save the Children, and Devendra Tak, who's a co-author, and it's a teamwork that sort of really led to such wonderful stories, and our urge is for you to read those stories because these are precious stories that we bring to you. Our children, Salman, who joins us all the way from Delhi, Shailendra from your very own Rajasthan, from Tonk district, Julima, who is joining us from Odisha. And we would really like to ask Sanjoy to join us, because without whom, this opportunity, we standing before you, presenting you something very special, wouldn't have been possible. So before we start with the formal proceedings, we are also waiting for erstwhile Princess Diya Kumari to join us, who's also a member of parliament. But in the meanwhile, we would really urge Sanjoy to say a few words as to why this opportunity and more such books and words should reach the audience and the readers is really important. Sanjoy, over to you.
Thank you so much, Pragya. Thank you, Bidisha. How many of you know what Save the Children does? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm actually going to, for 5 seconds, get Bidisha to say a few words of what Save the Children does before I say a few words.
Thank you so much, Sanjoy. And I've just seen our chairman emeritus, Dr. Arun Myra, here in the audience. So he would probably be better, but I will take the opportunity. Save the Children is a 100-year-old movement that started in the UK 100 years ago, has been working in India for the last 50 years to ensure that every single child, especially the most deprived, are able to realize and access their basic rights, which includes health, nutrition, education, and protection. So that's what we do in a nutshell. And the stories you're going to hear today are about some wonderful children who've not just changed their own lives, but the lives of many others.
Thank you, Bidisha. How many of you in the audience are below the age of 25? So do you know that the future belongs to you? You all are the people who are going to bring about change, not us. Our time is over. It's your time. And what Save the Children does is ensures the future of every child. I know this from personal experience, because Save the Children works with an organization that I'm part of, which is Salam Balak Trust. Salam Balak Trust brings children who have run away from home, gives them a future, gives them an opportunity. And like Salam Balak Trust, they work with countless organizations across the world and across India. So why do we need these children to tell their stories? Our belief is that for every one child who's successful, for every child whose voice can be heard, there will be 100 children out there who will make an effort to change the way that their lives have been happening. So for all of those children, a big round of applause to Save the Children Front for making this happen. Today's book, written by Rashmi and Devendra, is We Are the Champions. From a girl who was trafficked from the Sundarbans near Kolkata, who finds her way to the UN General Assembly in New York to speak to the world leaders, to a boy who grew up in the streets of New Delhi, like Salman from Salam Balak Trust, making his mark in Bollywood, while another uses rap music to spread awareness of health and hygiene in the city's slums. We Are the Champions is the story of 15 boys and girls from across India who often, against daunting odds, have struggled to improve their lives of other underprivileged children and to bring improvement in society. Please congratulate our writers, Rashmi and Devendra, for making this happen. Welcome to Diya Kumari, Member of Parliament, and I will come back to release the book in a while. Pragya.
Thank you so much, Sanjoy. We could not have asked for a better introduction to the book and the work that not just Save the Children, but so many partners like us, especially Salaam Balak Trust, has been doing over the years. We're delighted, actually, to be launching this book here today with all of you. It's quite special that it happens to be Republic Day, a day when we also celebrate a constitution which sort of enshrines principles of equality, fraternity, voice, freedom of speech, and those are exactly the same principles which are enshrined in the United Nations Convention on Rights of the Child, which would sort of demand that it is upon us as caregivers of children, as governments, as parents, as civil society organizations, to ensure that every child ensures their right to survive, to learn, to thrive, and to participate, and to have a voice in their own development and in shaping their own story and future. So today is a day where we want to hear from some of these children themselves. The book, as Sanjoy said, captures just 15 of the stories. But there are so many of these children. We ourselves are working with over 1,500 of these children across the country. We would like to hear from some of them in first person today. And it's just fantastic that we've had this book, which captures 15 of these stories, which we hope will go on to be an inspiration to many, many more. So I'd like to start with you, Rashmi, who partnered with us to write this. And in, as Rashmi says herself, that, you know, initially she was not super excited about the idea. But I want to know, Rashmi, as you went along, that changed. So what was your aha moment when you met these 15 children across the country, when you heard from them? What was it that you experienced?
Well, I'm a storyteller, and the kind of stories I enjoy telling are the inspiring stories of real people. And I started out this journey by writing about first-generation Indian entrepreneurs. And then I got attracted to this idea of social entrepreneurship because, you know, that has an even bigger impact when people work to make change happen in society. So I wrote a book on Akshay Patra Foundation. So I'm always looking for something new to tell. And when Devendra first proposed this idea of a book on children, I was a little skeptical because in my mind, the thought was that really, what can a child do? Can a child be a change maker? Because a child is in a developmental phase and maybe they don't have that agency or that power to do anything. So then he said, well, why don't you meet some of the children and decide for yourself? And then that's how I actually went and met some of the children. I met Salman in Delhi. I met Saleha in Mumbai in the Govandi slum. I think the first thing I realized was that this is a place I pass almost every week, and I have no idea about how people are living in this place, which is right next to the, you know, a mountain of garbage, like in Bombay's biggest dumping ground. And right next to that, we have children growing up in that environment. And then to meet a girl like Saleha, you know, who has fought with her parents to get an education. It's something that we take for granted. My daughter can take it for granted that she will go to college, but Saleha cannot take it for granted. And I think for me, the real turning point was when I met Julie Ma. I went to Odisha. She lives in a very remote village, which is about 7 hours drive from Bhubaneswar. And the last 10 kilometers are actually just not even a proper road. And jab main aapko mili Julie Ma, to mujhe बहुत अच्छा लगा क्योंकि I said this is such a remote part of India. Suppose in New Delhi we have a court which passes a law, we have a legislature which says that child marriage is illegal. But who is going to implement that law in this location? Will the police come and do it? Will the government come and do it? No, it's children like her who have first of all stood their ground and said that I will not allow this to happen to me. And then they have fought for their own community, other girls in their village. So I think this model that you have created, where you have empowered children, is a very powerful model. Because children know what's going on with other children. If there is a child marriage scheduled in the next village, they get to know first. And I think in conjunction with services like Childline, this has really created a great impact. So I'm very grateful to all of you for, you know, giving me a peek into this wonderful work you're doing, which is very hard work. It's like, I'm sure you train maybe hundreds of children, and from that some leaders emerge, and these are the young people we are seeing here today. So more power to you. And it just gives us a little hope that things can change and they can improve. And I'm sure that they will go on to become role models as young adults as well.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Rashmi. It's fantastic to hear that, a third-party external validation of what we try to do. Salman, aap to matlab kya main bolu? Aap hero ho, hamare liye hero ho. Aap jaise aur bachcho ke liye aap khud hero ho. Salman's story is incredible. He's grown up on the streets of Delhi. He struggled with so many difficult situations, which are captured in the book, which I hope all of you will read. But I think when Salman, we met Salman and with Salam Balak Trust, one of the first things he said was ki hum jaise bacche to invisible hain, hamara koi naam nahi hota, hamari pehchan nahi hoti. And I think that inspired us at Save the Children to launch our campaigns called The Invisible, where we campaign to get children living in street situations like Salman and identity and access to their rights. And I'm so pleased to say that inspired by him, we have been able to now reach out to nearly 3 lakh such children across the country. So Salman, aap apne bare mein thoda sa bataiye. Aapki kahani to book mein likhi hai, par aap ye bataiye ki ye jo pehchan ki baat aapne hame batai thi Save the Children ko, wo kyun itna mahatva rakhta hai aap apne liye aur aapke liye? Aapne uske liye kya kiya aur aapko kya lagta hai ki aage jaake उस चीज को लेकर आपके अरमान क्या है?
पहले तो मैं ये कहना चाहूंगा कि पहचान, क्योंकि देखिए कैसा रहेगा, एक छोटी सी बात मैं आप लोगों से कहना चाहूंगा, बुरा मत मानिएगा उस बात का, ठीक है? आप हैं, आप पढ़े लिखे हैं, लेकिन कैसा लगेगा अगर जो आपको कोई छोटू कह के बोला, ए छोटू इधर आ, हर्ट होगा ना? ये कहीं ना कहीं, मैं एक छोटी सी चीज मैं बताता हूं, क्योंकि मैंने भी जब मैं चाय की दुकान पे मैं काम करता था, मेरा नाम सलमान है, लेकिन किसी को पता नहीं था और ना ही किसी ने ये जानने की कभी कोशिश की कि इसका असली नाम क्या होगा. मुझे छोटू कहा जाता था चाय की दुकान पे. क्यों भाई, क्या हमारी पहचान नहीं है? हम भले ही हम सड़क पे रहते हैं, ठीक है, या हम भीख मांगते हैं, या हम जो भी करते हैं, लेकिन हमारी भी पहचान है. और एक चीज मैं बताना चाहूंगा कि आप मेरे जैसे हजारों बच्चों को देखते होंगे सड़कों पर, रेड लाइट पर, यहां तक कि अपनी गाड़ी का शीशा खटखटाते हुए भी. लेकिन आपको पता है, लोग ऐसा नहीं कि वो किसी को दिखते नहीं है, लोग उन्हें देखते हैं मगर उन्हें देख के नजरअंदाज कर देते हैं. और यही एक वजह है कि अगर जो आप किसी बच्चे की मदद करना चाहेंगे ना, क्योंकि मैं एक चीज, क्योंकि मैंने ऑब्जर्व किया है, जो कि बहुत से गाड़ी वालों को मैंने देखा है बच्चों के साथ ऐसे बदतमीजी से बात करते हुए, उनको मारते हुए, ठीक है, लेकिन आप अगर जो अच्छे दिल से अगर जो आप उससे बात करना चाहेंगे ना, तो वो आपसे बात नहीं करेगा, क्योंकि उसके अंदर कहीं ना कहीं इस चीज का डर लगा रहेगा कि कब ये पता नहीं मेरे साथ कौन सा सलूक कर बैठे. और इसके जिम्मेदार हम खुद हैं, और हमें उनको उन, क्योंकि देखिए मैं हूं, मेरे साथ के लोग क्या सोचते हैं, अरे भाई इसको तो चांस मिल गया, ये आगे निकल गया, लेकिन नहीं, ये मेरा चांस नहीं, ये मेरा हक था, और ये मेरे जैसे हजारों लाखों बच्चों का हक है जो उन्हें मिलना चाहिए।
थैंक यू सलमान, आप याद दिलाने के लिए कि ये हर बच्चे का हक है। जुलीमा, मैं आपके पास आती हूँ। आपकी कहानी भी बहुत कठिन है। उड़ीसा में आप बहुत रिमोट एरिया में रहते हैं। शी एज रश्मि राइटली सेड, व्हेन वी थिंक एज सेव द चिल्ड्रन ऑफ रीचिंग द मोस्ट मार्जिनलाइज्ड एंड मोस्ट अंडरसर्व्ड, आई थिंक द एरिया दैट शी कम्स फ्रॉम रिप्रेजेंट्स दैट। एंड इन दोज एरियाज बेसिक एक्सेस टू बेसिक हेल्थ सर्विसेज, आंगनबाड़ी सर्विसेज फॉर न्यूट्रिशन, schools, and especially when girls start growing up, primary school tak to ho jata hai, but fir secondary school jaane ke liye bahut dur jana padta hai, and that is when girls start dropping out. To Jhulima ki kahani bhi kuch aisi hi thi ki bachpan mein usko school chhodna pada, aur fir uski shaadi hone wali thi, par usne ghar mein apne parents ko samjhaya ki wo nahi karna chahti hai, wo aur aage padhna chahti hai, aur us inspiration se wo apne gaon mein aur apne aas paas aise aur bahut sare bacche hain jinko wo wapas school mein usne enroll kiya hai aur and has prevented their marriage. To Jhulima, aap apne shabdon mein kuch bataiye ki aapka ye jo journey tha wo kaisa raha, aapke vichar kya hai, aap kya kehna chahte hain in sab se?
थैंक यू। मैं झुलीमा मल्लिक ओडिशा से आई हूँ। तो मैम, मेरा जो जर्नी है, हमारा गांव पे जो लड़की रहते हो उसका जो पढ़ाई करना है, तो इसलिए मैं देखती हूँ कि वहाँ हमारा गांव के लड़कियों का उसका पिता माता उसको पढ़ने के लिए स्कूल और जाना चाहते हैं, लेकिन उसको पढ़ना नहीं देती है। तो मैं भी ऐसे ही, तो हमारा परिवार में हमारा पिताजी, हमारा माता, मेरा भी जो मैरिज फिक्स कर रही थी, तो मेरा भी आगे जाना है, आगे बढ़ना है। एक लड़की जो आगे बढ़ना है तो उसको क्यों और पीछे टालना है? तो मैं देखती हूँ हमारा गांव में जो भी लड़कियां वो स्कूल में जा रही है किसी परिवार में, उसको थोड़ा सा आगे जाने के लिए देती नहीं है। तो इसलिए मेरा थोड़ा सा, जो मैं ओडिशा से हूँ तो माफ कीजिए, मेरा हिंदी लटक जाएगी। तो क्योंकि हमारा जो डिस्ट्रिक्ट, हमारा जो जिला कंधमाल जिला, वहाँ पे ट्राइबल आदिवासी, मैं एक आदिवासी लड़की हूँ, तो जो लड़की ओडिया भी अच्छा तरह से नहीं बोलती है, वो आज यहाँ पे हिंदी में आप सभी लोगों के साथ बात कर रही है। तो इसके जिम्मेदारी में सेव द चिल्ड्रेन और हमारा जो साथी एनजीओ है उसको मैं धन्यवाद देती हूँ। तो मेरे को आज इतना ऊपर और आगे लेकर आए हैं। तो मैम, मेरा कहानी आप सब लोगों के बीच में बोलना चाहती हूँ। तो मेरा भी, मैं जब 10th तक पढ़ाई की हूँ तो हमारा घर लोगों ने मेरा बाल विवाह करने के लिए वो पूरा डिसीजन ले रही थी। तो मैं आगे जाकर मैं खुद का पैर में खुद तेरे कर मैं किस बनना चाहती हूँ। तो हमारा परिवार को मैं समझाई और बहुत समझाई, बहुत मेहनत करना पड़ा है मुझे उसको समझाने के लिए। तो मैं बहुत उसको बहुत बार समझाई और उसके बाद वो मेरा बात मान ली और मुझे आगे जाने के लिए मेरा जो मैरिज फिक्स हुई थी उसको भी वो मना कर लिया। तो इसलिए मुझे आगे बढ़ने के लिए जो सेव द चिल्ड्रेन जो अपॉर्चुनिटी दी, तो मैं बहुत खुश की मेरा जो हमारा गांव में हमारा डिस्ट्रिक्ट में जो बाल विवाह हो रही है उसको मैं कैसे मिटाऊंगी। तो मैं जो बाल विवाह का जो हमारा जो प्रोजेक्ट और जो शादी बच्चे का खेल नहीं है, तो मैं आप सब लोगों के बताएंगे जो लड़की आगे बढ़ना चाहती है, आगे जाना चाहती है, उस लड़कियों के क्यों हम आगे जाने के मौका देती नहीं है। तो इसलिए हमारा गांव में जो लड़कियों लड़कियां हैं, तो मैं इतना ही कहूंगी जो बाल विवाह कर रहे हैं उसको कैसे हम मिटाएंगे, और जो बाधा है उसको हम सब लड़कियों मिलकर वहाँ पे हम ग्रुप गठन करके जो बाल विवाह रोकने के लिए हम प्रयास कर रही हूँ। और इस प्रयास में तो हमारा बहुत सार कठिन पथ देकर हम जा रहे हैं। तो हमारा गांव एक ऐसे गांव जिस गांव में गाड़ी नहीं है, रास्ता जाने के लिए रास्ता भी नहीं है, और मार्केट 10 किलोमीटर दूर है, तो हम वहाँ पे पैदल के जाना पड़ते हैं। तो बीच में जो जंगल गांव है, जो जंगल है वहाँ पे भालू भी आ जाता है थोड़ा सा, तो हम वहाँ पे बहुत मुश्किल पे जा रहे हो। तो इसलिए मैं जो आज यहाँ पे है, आज जो आपके सामने मेरे बात रखी है, तो मैं रश्मि मैम को बहुत धन्यवाद दे रही हूँ कि वो मेरा घर पे आकर मेरा स्टोरी बारे में मुझे पूछे, और हमारा घर का सब हमारा माँ हमारा भैया और हमारा जो परिवार सब लोगों के साथ मिलकर हमारा घर पे आई थी, और हम और मेरा भी कहानी लिखी थी।
थैंक यू। शादी बच्चों का खेल नहीं है, ये अपने ग्रुप्स में मैसेज फैला रही है झूली माँ। देव, यू हैव बीन विथ सेव द चिल्ड्रन नाउ फॉर मेनी इयर्स, यू वर्क्ड क्लोजली विथ मेनी ऑफ दीज चिल्ड्रन, येट आई थिंक व्हेन यू took it upon yourself to write some of their stories yourself, there was something that spoke to you and inspired you. What I want to ask you, Dev, is what do you feel, what is that moment of change that really happens when you speak to these children? What do you see that's different from so many other children who we work with on a day in and day out basis?
Thank you, Vidisha. So of course, you know, having worked with Save the Children, also with the International Red Cross for many, many years now, and before that as a journalist, I met many children in vulnerable communities in India and around the world. So I can tell you stories about Somalia, where I've seen children being left to die on the roadside because their family can't afford to spend $5 to take them to the hospital to get treatment. So while we sit here in Jaipur, we can't imagine the situation of children, and the dire situation of children in different parts of the world. But coming back to India, Rashmi kept telling me, why don't you write a book, because I was a journalist earlier. I could never find anything inspiring to write about. But then among all these horrible stories of things not going right, of children not getting education, children getting married early, children being engaged in child labor, and all the chotus of the world, when I met these children, and we met about 30 odd children, whose stories were like really so compelling. We all come here because we enjoy stories. And I can assure you that each of these 15 stories here is different, and it's spectacular, because you talk about Salman, his story is better than a Bollywood movie story. Just try and read the story, you'll see what the story is all about. You'll read a story about a girl called Anju Verma, who lives in Haryana, and she's a cotton picker. She's to pluck cotton in the fields and from a Dalit family, and one day she's putting her hand in the bush and she almost gets bitten by a snake. So imagine the torture that children go through in their lives, which we can't even imagine. So I think our stories were able to, capture those instances of stories. And of course, Rashmi also mentioned, despite all the work that she's done in the past, this is so radically different. And Jhulema, she talked about, being really the invisible child. Trust me, the government is doing a great job across the country, but to reach these invisible children in such cut-off places, it's impossible for government to reach regularly and for NGOs. So I think the reason was to get these stories out so people can support the cause, and children can also be inspired to be change makers. So the reason is to, help all of us here to understand that there are amazing children out there who are also doing great stuff. And it's not just the adults who can do, or create change, but there are living examples here of children who have brought amazing change to the community. We talk about Greta, we talk about Malala, but we got much better Greta than Malala than India, and we've got to talk about them. So we are just 15 children here. I hope you read the book and find many more such children to support. That's my aspiration.
Thank you. Our own very own Indian Chulimas or Salmans or Shailendra. Shailendra, aap Rajasthan se ho. Aap Tonk mein bahut bahut se aap bhi aapne bhi shuru kiya tha bal vivah ko lekar. But fir aapke gaon mein bahut sare aur bhi mudde the. Un sab cheezon ko lekar aap ek matlab kya main bolu, ek it's almost like a crusade chalaye ho aap. To aap apni kahani संक्षिप्त में यहाँ पे रखिए और मुझे लगता है कि इन ऑडियंस से आप ये भी इनको बताइए कि ये कैसे जुड़ सकते हैं. आपको क्या लगता है कि आप जैसे जो बच्चे हैं, सलमान हैं, आप हो, झुलीमा है और ऐसे बहुत सारे हैं बच्चे, कैसे जुड़ सकते हैं यहाँ पे जो ऑडियंस बैठी है जिन्होंने नहीं सुनी आप जैसे बच्चों की कहानी इससे पहले.
थैंक यू मैम. मेरी कहानी तो किताब के अंदर सबको मिल जाएगी, लेकिन मैं आपको कुछ अलग बताना चाहता हूँ. सबसे पहले तो सभी को गणतंत्र दिवस की हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं. मैं शुरुआत करूंगा चाइल्ड राइट्स क्या होते हैं और कब इनकी शुरुआत हुई थी. संयुक्त राष्ट्र संघ, जो कि सभी देशों का एक संघ होता है, उसने 11 नवंबर 1882 को उनको लगा कि जो बच्चों की स्थिति है उसको सुधारने के लिए बच्चों के लिए कुछ अधिकार होने चाहिए, तो उन लोगों ने बच्चों के लिए अधिकार डिसाइड किया. फिर गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया ने 11 नवंबर 1992 को जो बच्चों के कुछ उसी घोषणा को अंगीकृत किया. उनमें से मैं कुछ बताना चाहूँगा, जैसे कि बच्चों के जो आवश्यक चीज़ें होती हैं उनको मिलने अनिवार्य होनी चाहिए, उनकी सुरक्षा होनी चाहिए, सुरक्षा सुरक्षित पूर्ण वातावरण मिलना चाहिए, उनको निःशुल्क शिक्षा मिलनी चाहिए, उनको पोषण मिलना चाहिए, स्वास्थ्य मिलना चाहिए, आदि चीज़ें उनको रेगुलरली मिलनी चाहिए. उसमें सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट आती है सुरक्षा. सुरक्षा हुआ, शिक्षा हुआ, सब कुछ ये चीज़ें हैं जो बच्चों को मिलना अनिवार्य है. सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट चीज़ है कि सुरक्षा. अभी हम सुरक्षा को लेकर बात तो कर रहे हैं और कितने सालों से, मैंने बताया लमसम संयुक्त राष्ट्र संघ ने तो आज के 140 सालों से पहले ये घोषणा कर दी और भारत सरकार ने भी लमसम 30 सालों से ये सब कुछ अधिकार जो है बना दिए बच्चों के लिए. लेकिन आज भी हम सुरक्षा की बात करते हो तो मैं अभी रिसेंटली न्यूज बताता हूँ टोंक की. अभी टोंक में 4-5 महीने पहले 6 साल की लड़की के साथ रेप हुआ था. वो भी स्कूल के कंडक्टर ने उसके साथ ऐसा किया था, क्योंकि पेरेंट्स तो बच्चों को स्कूल बस में इसलिए बैठाते कि वो सेफ्टी से स्कूल जाएगी और उसको वहाँ पे कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होगी, लेकिन फिर भी उसके साथ ऐसा सब कुछ हुआ है और उसको मार भी दिया गया है. मैं ये नहीं कहता कि गवर्नमेंट कुछ नहीं कर रही है, गवर्नमेंट बहुत कुछ कर रही है और गवर्नमेंट को भी बहुत कुछ करने की ज़रूरत है बच्चों के लिए, लेकिन फिर भी हमें भी आगे आना चाहिए और हमें भी कुछ करना चाहिए, क्योंकि हम सब चाहते हैं हमारा देश एक विकासशील राष्ट्र है, उससे विकसित राष्ट्र बने. हम सब चाहते तो हैं, लेकिन हम सब कब ये कब पॉसिबल होगा, जब हमें हमारा देश का जो फ्यूचर है उसको सही शिक्षा मिलेगी, सही स्वास्थ्य मिलेगा, सही एजुकेशन मिलेगा, उसके सही पोषण मिलेगा. हम सब ये चाहते हैं कि हमारा देश विकसित राष्ट्र की तुलना में आए विकासशील राष्ट्र से, लेकिन हम उनको वो चीज़ नहीं दे पा रहे हैं. हम कहते हैं कि आप हमें हमारा अच्छा प्रेजेंट दीजिए, हम आपको आपका देश का अच्छा फ्यूचर देंगे, क्योंकि हमें जब तक आप हम जब तक शिक्षित नहीं होंगे, जब तक पोषित नहीं होंगे, तब तक आपका देश का फ्यूचर कहाँ ब्राइट होगा. हम तो आपसे यही कहते हैं कि आप हमें अच्छा प्रेजेंट दीजिए, हम आपके देश को अच्छा फ्यूचर देंगे. धन्यवाद.
थैंक यू सो मच शैलेंद्र. The spark that one sees in these children is just so infectious, which is why when we go to the field and we spend time with these children, you come back just wanting to do more and more. We're very honored to have with us today Diya Kumari Ji, Member of Parliament and Asphalt Princess. Diya Kumari Ji, just wanted to hear your reflections. You have heard these stories of these children. You also know a little bit about the work that Save the Children does. Just any reflections you have listening to Salman, Shailendra and Julima's story, and of course Rashmi and Dev as well.
Thank you so much, and wishing everyone a very happy Republic Day. It's overwhelming hearing about their stories, and I'd like to thank the authors. I'm very, very grateful to you to having brought these stories and written about them. You know, how many people really write about children? How many people write about real life stories? And I am so proud that I am here on this stage with these brave soldiers of our country. These are the future of our country. And I wish, you know, their stories are going to inspire many more. And they have made a difference, of course, to their lives, but to many others as well. तो आप तीनों को बहुत बहुत बधाई. आप लोगों ने हमारे देश का नाम रोशन किया है. आपने इतना बड़ा काम किया है जो बहुत सारे बच्चों को हिम्मत नहीं होती करने में. बहुत करेज की जरूरत होती है. यू नीड अ लॉट ऑफ करेज टू स्टैंड अगेंस्ट समटाइम्स योर फैमिली कम्युनिटी एंड समटाइम्स यू नो मच मोर देन दैट समटाइम्स इवन द कंट्री. सो इट्स आई मीन आई सल्यूट देयर करेज. आई विश दे वर मोर लाइक देम. I wish not only children, I'm sure a lot of us are inspired by their stories. And as a public representative, if there is anything I can do to help, to make any difference at all, I'd like to, you know, be there. I'm always there for children. I have worked with the Save the Girl Child campaign, with Beti Bachao. And there are many in the audience, Meeta ji, who have worked with me to stop child marriage. We have gone to Ganganagar, we have traveled all over Rajasthan, and it does make a difference. I think all of us as citizens, as you know, people, it's not only the responsibility of governments or administration, it is up to us as well. If we see something wrong being done to these children in any way, sometimes it is in our own homes, and many times it starts from there. You see, you know, a lot of abuse cases, child marriage. I mean, we'll see our neighbor doing something and we know about it. We'll see it happening in our own homes, but we don't raise our voices. We don't say anything. We quietly just say, oh, it's not our problem. Let's not get into it. It'll get us into litigation and whatever else. So I think it's all of us who are as much responsible as everyone else is, as much as the culprits, to actually just silently say nothing and just let all this go on. But of course, the authors, publishers, and of course, Save the Children. You are doing amazing work. I have worked with you before. And I am so honored to be here at this occasion. And anything at all I can do for these children and for the children, please let me know. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. I think, you know, you summed it up beautifully. In the sense that it's not just one person's responsibility. I think it's the responsibility of every single one of us. These children have chosen to take that responsibility, and they've stood up and they have voiced and expressed what is not right and stood up for their rights. So I think that sums it up beautifully. Salman, aap kuch kehna chahte the?
Main ye kehna chahunga ki matlab मैं जहां था और आज मैं आप लोगों के सामने हूं, इसमें बहुत लोगों का हाथ रहा है. मैं सेव द चिल्ड्रन का, सलाम बालक ट्रस्ट का, संजय रॉय सर का बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया अदा करना चाहता हूं. और हां, आज मैंने अपने बीते हुए कल से एक बात तो कह देनी है कि भले ही रफ्तार धीमी है मेरी, मगर मैं तुम्हारी पकड़ से बाहर हूं. और हां, एक चीज मैं आप लोगों से भी कहना चाहूंगा कि हौसलों की हर एक उड़ान बाकी है, हर मोड़ पर एक नया इम्तिहान बाकी है. अभी तक तो सिर्फ बचपन सवरा है हमारा, क्योंकि इसमें जो लोग हैं ना, उन्हीं का बचपन सवरा हुआ है ना. तो अभी तक तो सिर्फ बचपन सवरा है हमारा, अभी तो पूरा हिंदुस्तान बाकी है.
आप सबको मैं ये भी बता दूं कि सलमान एस्पायरिंग एक्टर क्या अभी एक्टर बन गए हैं. वो दो तीन फिल्मों में काम कर चुके हैं. पहाड़गंज करके फिल्म है, अगर आप लोगों ने नहीं देखी है तो जरूर देखिए. इट्स हिज ड्रीम टू बी एन एक्टर. सलमान खान नाम है तो ऑफ कोर्स दैट्स व्हाट हिज ड्रीम वुड बी. बट डू रीड द स्टोरी एंड इंस्पायर योरसेल्फ्स. थैंक यू सो मच टू ऑल माई को पैनलिस्ट्स हियर. इट्स बीन अ वंडरफुल डिस्कशन.
Before we leave, we would really like to invite all of us on stage. And could we also have Raghav Chadha, who is the young photographer who took photographs for this book. So please come on stage. Our chair emeritus, Arun Mairaji, if you're here, we would really like you to join us on stage. Okay. Step Can we step forward for the photo? And we have amongst us Mr. Vaibhav Gehlot also. Thank you so much for joining us and look forward to working with you to make the lives of children and their future really bright.